SpaceX works on closing all of the required items, to allow for the milestone orbital attempt. A sign of the test approaching was evident with the arrival of a Raptor vacuum engine, captured by NSF's Tyler Gray. The upper stage will use six of these engines with the monster nozzle. Citing Tyler's photo, Elon Musk updated the performance of the new engines, citing the RVAC achieved an ISP of 378, and SpaceX hopes to increase that number to 380 further down the road. In this video, we are going to look, SpaceX rapidly increasing the production of Raptor engine for the first orbital launch. We are also going to look at, SpaceX kick off Super Heavy's test campaign with first successful test. Starbase also saw the delivery of the initial R-Boost Raptor engines, which will make up the majority of the engines on the Super Heavy booster. They will provide improved thrust but no gimbal capability. RB3 and RB4 also arrived as part of a new trio of engines on Saturday. Next week Friday morning R-Boost Raptor engine RB5 arrived at the Starship production facilities. Today Elon Musk share Raptor engine photos on Twitter. As you can see, there are total 9 R-Boost Raptor engine, which is shipped in next 2 or 3 days. These all engine are fitted in the Super Heavy B4, for the first orbital launch attempt no earlier than end of August. From a paperwork standpoint, SpaceX is still waiting for the final go from the FAA, to perform the orbital launch, and the environmental authorities to provide approval to launch Super Heavy, from Boca Chica. In the meantime, SpaceX is still pushing through numerous Raptors from its Hawthorne production facility, through testing at McGregor, ahead of making the final road trip to Starbase. The photos from L2 McGregor, from NSF's Gary Blair recent flyover, showed 3 sea-level Raptors on the horizontal test stand facilities, once again providing an ever-increasing test cadence. This, in turn, allows for shipments of up to 3 Raptors at a time to Starbase, as observed last week. The stock of Raptors required for the upcoming orbital attempt is likely not the bottleneck to being ready for launch. Nevertheless, Booster 3 was spotted venting for the first time ever. Meshing with road and beach closures, requested earlier this week, NASA Spaceflight reports that, a SpaceX Super Heavy booster is scheduled to attempt a cryo-proof test, for the first time as early as Monday, July 12. Known as Booster 3, B3, SpaceX rolled the first functional Super Heavy prototype, the largest rocket booster ever completed, from the factory to the launch pad on July 1. 1 week later, SpaceX appears to be on track to kick off Super Heavy's first fully integrated qualification testing. Building off of an apparently successful campaign of pressure testing, with booster test tank BN2.1. After completing several tests, BN2.1 was rolled back to a scrapyard near SpaceX's Boca Chica factory. While part of the custom-built stand used for the campaign was then reinstalled on one of the 2 suborbital mounts used for Starship testing over the last year. Mere days after Mount A's modifications were completed, Super Heavy Booster 3 was transported to the pad and installed atop it. For whatever reason, SpaceX technicians and engineers spent the next week scouring the rocket's exterior and interior, with the help of an army of boom lifts, turning the basic structure into a functional pressure vessel, with all necessary power, telemetry, and plumbing. 99% of that closeout work could have seemingly been done, under the cover of SpaceX's high bay, where Booster 3 was assembled out of dozens of steel rings and domes, but the work appears to have been completed regardless. On Thursday, SpaceX engineers conducted a pressure test, at ambient temperature on the Super Heavy prototype, identified as Booster 3 feet. This test is typically performed ahead of a cryogenic proof test, meant to assess the stainless steel vehicle's structural integrity. It was the first time, SpaceX has performed a ground test on a Super Heavy prototype. Initially, the company planned to continue testing today, however, it is likely that they delayed testing, due to severe thunderstorms and flood watch warnings entering the Cameron County region this week. According to the county's road closure announcements, SpaceX targets to continue Booster 3 ground testing, starting on Monday, July 12 through Thursday, July 15. During timeframes scheduled from 12 noon to 10 p.m. road closures are necessary, to ensure safety parameters are established in the public beach zone, in case the vehicle implodes. Some rocket development tests require engineers to intentionally push a structure to its limit, to see how much the vehicle can withstand. During the upcoming cryogenic proof test, Booster 3 will be filled with super cold liquid nitrogen, to simulate the pressure that would be created by liquid methane and oxygen when the rocket's 29 Raptor engines are fueled. Passing this test will be crucial before engineers decide to move on to develop other aspects of the launch vehicle. The test could reveal any structural and design flaws that will enable engineers to improve the next prototype in line, Booster 4. Now seemingly, we can see Super Heavy B3 fully outfitted with all necessary avionics, wiring, and plumbing. Booster 3's next major objectives will be ambient and cryogenic proof tests, referring to the process of verifying the structural integrity of the rocket, first with Bagane nitrogen gas, and later with supercool liquid nitrogen. SpaceX has performed at least a dozen or two cryo proofs over the last 18 months, and at this point, qualification testing is fairly routine. However, Super Heavy B3 is the largest rocket booster ever built, and testing such a massive rocket will necessarily force SpaceX to tread some new ground. In fact, it's not actually clear how exactly SpaceX will perform Booster 3's first cryo proof, given that the suborbital launch complex hosting it has nowhere near enough cryogenic storage capacity to fully fill Super Heavy with more than 3,000 tons of liquid nitrogen. As always, testing massive, brand new rockets is no simple feat, so delays are possible, if no outright likely. SpaceX founder Elon Musk said that Booster 4 will be the first to conduct a test flight, or changing much of design from 3 to 4. Booster 3 was very hard to build. Expect especially rapid evolution in first approximately 10 boosters, and first approximately 30 ships, he stated. Meanwhile, a 400-foot-tall orbital launch tower is under construction. It will support the stacking operation of Starship, serial number 20, atop Super Heavy Booster 4. I think we can stack an orbital ship on an orbital booster in July, Musk said last week. SpaceX founder Elon Musk showed off the new Falcon 9 recovery drone ship called A Shortfall of Gravitas in a video he shared via Twitter on Friday afternoon. The sea-going platform is based upon barge Marmok 302 and features SpaceX technology to operate autonomously. It is designed to support the landing of rocket boosters in the ocean after they deploy spacecraft into orbit. A Shortfall of Gravitas will now join SpaceX's fleet of launch support drone ships called Of Course I Still Love You and Just Read the Instructions. SpaceX's drone ships have enabled the company to hold the world record for the highest rocket recovery and reusability. Since 2015, SpaceX has worked on its innovative rocket recovery system, using the autonomous drone ships and orbital-class rockets, capable of propulsive descent. Soon after Falcon 9 launches payload to orbit, the rocket's first stage booster returns to Earth, and lands atop one of the ocean platforms, which operates in the Pacific Ocean. This week, the company moved the drone ship to the West Coast to support missions launched from California. Now that A Shortfall of Gravitas will soon be in operation, it will enable the company to continue recovering rockets from the East Coast. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.